हेलो एवरीवन, माइसेल्फ श्वेता गोहिल एंड वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ माइक्रोवेव एंड रडार इंजीनियरिंग. इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल सी वेवगाइड्स, टाइप्स ऑफ वेवगाइड्स, पैरामीटर्स रिलेटेड टू वेवगाइड्स. वी विल सी इन डिटेल रेक्टेंगुलर वेवगाइड, सर्कुलर वेवगाइड एंड देन वी विल सी कंपैरिजन बिटवीन दिस टू वेवगाइड्स. नाउ लेट अस सी डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेवगाइड. वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन वेवगाइड डेफिनेशन इन द प्रीवियस सेशन. वेवगाइड इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन that is used to transmit or guide the wave or radiation along with the length of the tube. These are typically hollow metallic tube which are used as a medium to transfer or transmit power. In waveguides, the energy is propagated through the tube. It can be either rectangular or circular or cylindrical waveguide, and it does not consist any central conductor. A waveguide transmits microwave signal making continuous reflections from the inside walls of the tube. The walls of the waveguides are generally made up of copper, aluminium or brass. However, its inner surface is coated with gold or silver. Now let us see which are the different types of waveguide. Rectangular waveguide, circular waveguide, elliptical waveguide, single ridged waveguide and double ridged waveguide. But most commonly rectangular and circular waveguides are used. First of all, let us see parameters of waveguide which are to be considered. The first is cutoff wavelength. It is maximum signal wavelength of the transmitted signal that can be propagated within the waveguide without any attenuation. This means up to cutoff wavelength, the microwave signal can easily transmitted through the waveguide, and it is denoted by lambda c. Second parameter is group velocity. It is velocity with which wave propagates inside the waveguide. If the transmitted carrier is modulated, then the velocity of modulation envelope is somewhat less as compared to the outer signal. This velocity of envelope is termed as group velocity, which is indicated by Vg. Next term is phase velocity. It is velocity with which the transmitted wave changes its phase during the propagation. Or we can say it is basically the velocity of particular phase of propagating wave, and it is denoted by Vp. Now the last parameter is wave impedance. It is also known as characteristic impedance, but as we are dealing with waveguides, we will consider it as wave impedance. It is defined as ratio of transverse electric field to the ratio of transverse magnetic field, but during the wave propagation. It is denoted by Zg. Now we will see in detail different types of waveguides. Starting from rectangular waveguide, all the name of waveguide are given according to the cross section of it. Like rectangular waveguide has a rectangular cross section having the width A and height B. A rectangular waveguide is basically characterized by its dimensions, that is length A and breadth B, in which it will propagate TE mode and TM mode. This diagram shows how the TE mode and TM mode propagates, in which red lines are showing magnetic field, whereas blue lines indicate electric field. Here we have shown TE mode as well as TM mode. TEMN and TMMN. This M and N indicates how much X direction and Y direction will propagate the electromagnetic waves. Now what do you mean by dominant mode? A waveguide supports more than one propagation mode. Dominant mode propagates with minimum degradation. Dominant mode has lowest cutoff frequency. For rectangular waveguide, TE10 is dominant mode, and for circular waveguide, TE11 is the dominant mode. Here you can see how the wave propagates. Like if we are considering TE10 mode, then along with the A, that is X direction, it will have only half of the pulse. In TE20, you can see two half cycles propagates through the X direction. And in TE30, three half cycles propagate in x direction. This is the simulation of rectangular waveguide shown over here. Now we will see circular waveguide, in which circular waveguide has circular cross section with the radius a or r. The dominant mode of circular waveguide is TE11, and here you can see the simulation of circular waveguide. The next is elliptical waveguide, in which it has cross section of elliptical shape. Here you can see electromagnetic waves, in which blue line indicates electric field whereas red line indicates magnetic field. This is single ridged waveguide with a single protruding ridge from the top or the bottom, which is known as single ridged waveguide. And in double ridged waveguide, top and bottom walls are protruded, and that is known as double ridged waveguide. Okay, now we will see comparison between circular waveguide and rectangular waveguide. Rectangular waveguide has rectangular cross section. Circular waveguide has circular cross section. The dominant mode in rectangular waveguide is TE10, whereas in circular waveguide it is TE11. Here it is shown the comparison between modes of the rectangular and circular waveguide. The area required is less for same cutoff frequency in rectangular waveguide, but in circular waveguide it is 2.17 times larger than the rectangular waveguide. In this rectangular waveguide, plane of polarization does not change, but in circular waveguide, as the axes are radial, the plane of polarization rotates during the wave travels through the waveguide. Rectangular waveguides are difficult to manufacture as compared to circular waveguide, and circular waveguides are easier to manufacture as compared to rectangular waveguide. Rectangular waveguides are not easy to join together, but circular waveguides are easy to join together. In rectangular waveguide, M indicates number of half wave variation in x direction, that is A. And in circular waveguide, M indicates half variation in side A. A is radius of the circular waveguide. In rectangular waveguide, N indicates number of half wave variation in y direction, which is side B. And whereas in circular waveguide, N indicates number of half wave intensity changes radially out from the center of the wall. That's all about the comparison of rectangular and circular waveguide. Let us move towards the session of assignment. Question number 1, define the important parameters related to waveguide. Question number 2, explain different types of waveguides. Third, explain rectangular waveguide in detail. And fourth, explain circular waveguide in detail. That's all for the today's session. See you in the next session. Thank you.
If you like this video, please subscribe and like our YouTube channel LJPEC-ELE. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get latest video update first.